In this video, we're going to learn how to derive the area of a circle. Okay, the formula, precisely the formula for the area of the circle. So, first we're going to draw a picture in the xy plane. So, use a black color. And I'm going to draw a circle through it. I'm going to center the circle at the origin, like that. Okay. And let's see. So I'm just going to label the X. I'm going to label the Y. And let's label the radius of the circle. It's going to be centered at the origin. So let's label the radius as simply r. Okay? So this x value of the point on the circle on the x-axis will be labeled r. And this point will be labeled negative r, obviously. So now, as you know, the area is pi r squared. So we need to derive this formula. A is equal to pi r squared. Now, in order to do this, you will use polar coordinates. Okay, you will use polar coordinates and a double integral. Okay, so a double integral that you're going to use will determine the region over which you're integrating, the function of the radius and the angle theta, and the dA. Okay? Now the region will be determined by the angle range for the first integral, and for the second integral it's going to be the radius range. Okay? So as you know, it's centered at the origin, the circle here in this case. So let's talk about the angle. As you know, to go around the circle, you will have traveled 360 degrees. So you will have traveled 2 pi radians. So the range of the angle is going to be from 0 to 2 pi, right? Because if you want to wind up at the same point that you started with, you will have traveled 2 pi radians, right? So we can label the first integral from 0 to 2 pi. Now the second integral is going to be the range of the radius. But first of all, let me clarify what this theoretical integral is. So as I've noticed already, as I've noted, the angle will be ranging from alpha to beta, right? In this case, alpha is 0 and beta is 2 pi, right? This determines the range, right? The limits for the angle. Now the second integral will determine limits for the radius. So you can think of it as a function of theta, the first function, and the second function of theta. Now this function need not be a variable function, it could be a constant function for the radius, right? But in any case, now fr, the function of the radius and theta, of course, in the integrand, and finally dA. Now dA translates to r dr d theta. Okay, that's what dA means, right? Because essentially A is the area. That's why dA breaks up into the r dr d theta. Okay, now here in this case, if you have a double integral and you're trying to determine the area, then the function of the radius and theta, the angle, will be always equal to 1 when you are using a double integral in polar coordinates to determine the area. Okay, so it's going to be equal to 1. Okay, so now let's determine the range of the radius now. So the range of the radius is going to be from 0 to r, right? Because this guy is also equal to r, and this guy is equal to negative r, right? So notice that the radius, the maximum value of the radius is going to be r, right? From the center to the edge, always, no matter where you go. The absolute value here is also going to be r, even though it says negative r, right? But the absolute value is going to be r, the distance. So the maximum distance from the center of the circle to the edge will always be r, right? So the range of the radius will be 0. In this case, is the first function as a function of theta is 0. And then the second one is going to be, the upper limit is going to be r for the radius, right? Because that's the maximum value. And keep in mind that the r value, in this case, is a constant. Even though the r happens to also be the variable for the first integral, it also plays a role as a constant, right? And this will help us determine, arrive at this formula for the area of the circle. Okay, now you might be confused as to why is this g, why are these two g's function of theta? Well, they're functions of theta because suppose that you had those theta, right, in there. Suppose that it was a function of theta. Then when you actually use those limits, you will have something dealing with theta for the last integral. And that's exactly what you have remaining because you will have d theta, right? So the last integral, the outer integral, that is, or the first integral, whatever you want to call it, will deal with angle theta. So we're allowed to think of the radius as the function of theta. Okay, so in this case, the functions of theta are from 0 to r, right? Those are the ranges of the radius. So now let's substitute everything in the integrand. So the function of the radius and theta is going to be 1, as we determined when you're using a double integral in polar coordinates to determine the area, right? So it's going to be 1 times r dr d theta, r dr d theta. Okay, so now it's easy to integrate, right? Keep the first integral, solve the inner integral first, right? So the variable is r. So it turns into 1 half r squared, okay, from 0 to r. So once again, keep in mind that the r here happens to also be the variable and the constant, right? So don't be confused by that, right? And then this whole thing, right, this whole thing will be then integrated with respect to theta. After that, right? So let's keep going from 0 to 2 pi. So we will have 1 half r squared d theta, right? Because the 0 will not affect the r when you put in the limits into the r, right? You put the r into the r squared, it just simply becomes itself, r squared, right? You put the 0, it's not affected, right? Because subtracting 0 does not change the first quantity that you're subtracting from if it's non-zero, right? So then you can take the 1 half out, so you will have from 0 to 2 pi r squared d theta, right? And then finally you're gonna, well, actually, you know what, I should have taken the r squared out as well, so 1 half r squared, because right now the r squared is going to be the constant because we're integrating with respect to theta, right? So it's going to be 1 times d theta. So it turns into 1 half r squared, right, times theta from 0 to 2 pi, right? Because 1 turns to theta when you integrate with respect to theta, right? So that becomes 1 half r squared, and then let's let's put in the limits upper and lower into the theta here, right? So it's going to be 2 pi put in the theta minus 0, the lower limit put into the theta, right? So that becomes 1 half r squared times 2 pi, and guess what happens? These twos these twos, they get canceled out, right? And we're left with pi r squared. Okay, so that was the formula for the area. Okay, and as you see, we did arrive at this famous area formula of the circle. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video beneficial. Please subscribe if you want, and I'll see you in my next video.